morning. I'm Kim from Inspirations Glass and Gifts, and yes, I am crouching at my workstation here, but that's just so the video can see me before I stand up and show you the lamp. So today we're going to work on a repair of a lamp. This is the Dragonfly lamp. It's absolutely beautiful when it has light come through it, but it is a Chinese mass-produced lampshade. That being said, this one in particular uses lead-free solder, which is a nightmare to get off, and it has no reinforcing. They use copper back foil because that's the cheapest. They also use the thinnest so that it left most of the glass exposed. The issue there is copperback foil has very little adhesive, and with not much foil to hold the solder, that left pieces vulnerable. The wind blew this one over and it disengaged the vase cap from the top, which, of course, the lampshade can no longer sit on the lamp. So we're going to save it, and it was dropped off a day and a half ago. It will be transported back to the States where it came from tomorrow. So I'm going to tip the camera and show you what we're doing. So feel free to shoot your questions while we're live. I will answer as much as I can, and after the fact, I can answer your questions when you're watching the video, when it's no longer live. And I've been asked to put it up on YouTube, so I will do my best to pay attention and answer anything that comes in at that point too. So one of the first things I like to do is use an ordinary baby wipe and wipe down the piece before I foil it. And why do I not have this already foiled so that you can just see the soldering? Is because not everybody knows exactly how to foil. So I'm drying off that piece that I just wiped with a old t-shirt, because t-shirt material does not leave lint on your project. Now, take your piece, turn your foil upside down so you see the back, and you see I'm using black back foil, and center your piece. Because this one has quite heavy texture, sometimes that's difficult, but I'm centering using the widest point, as the widest point here goes on the bottom. This allows me to keep my seams tucked in where they'll be the strongest. If I put that seam at the top, it'll join to the vase cap, and it pretty much creates a hinge joint. You don't want hinge joints on anything. And my scissors. Now, while I'm at it, my scissors are a bit tacky, and a real quick way to get the glue off of your scissor blades is to use regular lighting fluid, or lighter fluid. Just a dot, and wipe it off. No more sticky. So, I like to use my FID. And just push down the edge. I push down the widest edge first, because this gives me a place to grab hold of it. Go right up into those corners, make sure that you don't have any bumps. They do pierce your skin and they hurt. By the sounds of it, my granddaughter has just come into the studio behind me. Come here, Mia, say hi.
Who is it?
Right here. Come up here and say hi.
Who is it?
These are people that come to see my videos. Say hi.
Hi.
you get big, then you can watch all my videos too, and then you'll know how to do glass like Grandma.
Well, I'm on my tippy toes.
I know you're on your tippy toes.
I like being on my tippy toes.
Yeah, you also like looking at yourself on the camera, don't you? Yeah. Okay, BB, let Grandma do this. Okay, so you can see that that is pushed down. I'm going to use the FID and make sure that it's burnished flat to the glass. You want to actually close your eyes and feel with your finger. If you can still feel the foil, then it's not burnished flat enough. And this side with texture, go in between every single little bit of texture you can. If you have trouble getting in there, I like to use a wooden dowel. This one is actually for sharpening leather edges to smooth them out. The wood's a little bit more forgiving, so it doesn't rip your foil. And it gets into all those little bits. Okay, so you can see that that's nice and tight to the piece. Now, this is the last tier of the lamp. So I'm going to set my piece using my fingers to hold it even on this side and set it flush. Little trick here is to only put the solder where the one edge, which leaves them loose like teeth, and allows you to adjust your spacing when you put the vase cap on. So here's the last piece. Then we put the vase cap on, and I'll show you how to reinforce it. Grandma's busy, baby. Pardon?
What do you want for lunch?
What do I want for lunch?
Yeah.
A surprise. Thank you.
What surprise?
I don't know. Okay, so I'm done with the foil there. Burnish this last piece. And type in your questions if you have any as we're going. Try to give you as many tricks as I can while we're actually live. Just flattening my edges. Another nasty thing with the Chinese glasses, if you ever have to repair one, you're going to notice that the edges are usually not ground, which makes it a little bit more difficult to have a smooth edge to get the backing of the foil to stick to. So of course I did that before I turned the camera on. Okay, last piece goes in. Magically, it fits just perfect. Okay, so I'm going to put the vase cap on. And if you don't mark exactly which way it went, then you're going to have to turn it around to see. Okay, so holding that down, just going to tack it at several joints. I am putting a good amount of pressure on this so it doesn't move. You don't want it to pop up. Now, this particular vase cap had been soldered and patinaed. So you want to hold the flat of your iron tip against the vase cap, because you have to activate the solder that's underneath the patina, and that can take a second. You are going to have solder that runs down the lamp. Don't worry about it. It will flick off the glass after it's cooled. And this does get a little bit warm as you're working. As soon as I get these tacked down, I'm going to flip it over and work from the back side. Why would I do that without finishing the solder? Is because I want to create a solid connection from the back side to make sure that all the sections of this row are straight. You're not going to typically see a vase cap that's pushed in at the top like this. I have no idea why they did that, but we work with what we've got. These are really small pieces, so you don't want to take too much time resting your iron, as this is not the time you want to hear that telltale tink of a crack. Lamps are unique. You're going to make quite a mess while you work with your lamp. It's just the shape versus gravity. So you want to rotate it as you work to help stop that running. Now we have a vase cap. Yes, I could put this up now, and it would stay for a very long time, probably longer than you remembered not finishing it, but being that it won't be in my sight, pardon me, I don't want to do that to my client for it to break and then have to come back up. So, we're looking in from the bottom now. You see that well enough? Oh. Samuel says, the corners on the foil always give me trouble when I burnish. Yep. You want to fold them over like this. Think of the ladder that you make with hands. So you fold the first one down, and then you put the second one down, and you push that corner down from this side. And you keep doing that as you go. Okay, so we have the inside. So give it a good amount of flux. You're going to wash this all off later. I like to use gel flux. Stays where I put it instead of running around. Ruby red, it just burns off before you can get to it using the heat of the previous piece or pieces. So give yourself a little bit of a extension on the solder. Can you see all this? So now I'm going to go in and tack those corner joints so that they stay. I'm not worried about beading right now. I'm just flat soldering. Thanks, baby girl.
Surprise!
Oh my goodness!
Surprise!
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 Thanks so much!
Surprise!
Okay, can you put it on my desk? Thanks so much. Did you steal a bite?
I will.
You will? A bite or half the sandwich, eh? You silly. Okay, so nearly done this. Okay, guys, Grandma's working, please. Yummy in my tummy.
I know, she is gorgeous. Thanks, Brenda. Sellers, that's a family name.
Okay, so we're almost ready to here to reinforce. Now you see this little blob of solder? Don't touch it, it's hot.
So what I do now,
I'm just going to take a thin piece of galvanized steel. And although it's pretty flimsy, you might not think that it's going to do much, but it actually does. Due to the nature of lamps, where they don't have joins that line up nicely, you're going to create a zigzag effect. You don't have to do this for every single piece in the two tiers at the top. Think of a wheel. When you put a new wheel on your car, you do opposite sides, and then that stops them from, I don't know the technical terms there, it just joins them better. So I'm going to come down here, right into the actual pieces of the lamp, and I'm going to start there. Go down, can you see that? You want to go down about a half inch or so, and tack that in. Now remember, this is going to, the wire is going to act like a heat conduit. So you want to have your little pliers handy to grab hold of it. Okay. Oh, it's being a... When you're working with leaded solder and putting it into lead-free solder, you gotta give it a second to heat up to allow the two solders to mix together. And then hold it long enough to let it cool so it stays still. Okay, so got that joined into the actual body of the lamp. I'm going to come up the first tier, and using my pliers here, I'm going to bend the wire over. You see that okay? So this creates a stair step. So I'm going to tack that section. And then go back and join it. This helps it hide in the seams. So what we've just done here is allowed for the lamp to actually be supported from about two-thirds up from the base. So all the weight, instead of being hung from the base cap, is actually being transported down the lamp. That actually creates a stronger hold. And I've bent the wire down so that I can fix it right to the base cap, and I'll cut off my excess. Flux inside the base cap. Give yourself a little bit of easier working space here. Now that wire will not move. Okay, so the wire is joined to the base cap. Hi, Jean. Thanks so much. Okay, so I'm not going to work next door. I would actually skip one or two. So if I skip one, I want to go over here and do it the opposite side. So skipping one, one, two, three. You can mark that if you want to. I'm going to wash it off later anyway. Okay, so here's my join. It's there. So marking every other one. And if I'm staying to the right of my mark, going across here, then I would come up on this side here. So 4 or 6, but stay in pairs. That's going to help you secure your lamp. So I'll do one more for the sake of video, in case you looked away to sip your coffee or deal with a wee person in your studio. Cut myself a little length. Bring my flux down far enough. Again, about a quarter, half an inch, no less than half an inch. It's quarter inch often does it, but the lamp shade is already quite heavy to begin with. Forget to flex your wire as you move up. It's raining outside, which may not be a bad thing for a lot of people, but it's really humid here right now, and we need that humidity. We've had just 7 days now with no rain, and where that may not be remarkable to a lot of people, if you've been following on my page at all, you'll know that I'm in a flood zone, and some of my neighborhood has actually lost their home due to the waters. So that's two sides that are done. So just for the essence of being complete here, I'm going to show you that we do have some bleed through from the other side, and this is okay. So you want to tip up your good side. Always work from the inside first, then tip up to work on finishing the outside. This is the part that everybody's going to see and judge you on, basically. So this is where you need to match the existing foil, which for me, Chinese glass is flat soldered, and they're quick about it. Be quick too if I only got paid by piece.
But so I have to match the existing solder, and this means that I cannot run a nice bead. So you'll see in my other videos, and it's bleeding through, it's superheated. You'll see in my other videos that I show you soldering, and that is to run it up the joint just a little bit, and then you catch the spot where you finished, and that gives you a nice clean join. Okay, so before I shut the video off, I will come back when it's time to wax it up and show you how to clean and polish it, which of course will also show you the reveal of its being relit. Before I do that, is there anybody with any questions? You're very welcome, Samuel. Thanks so much. You're always there for wanting more videos. I hope that I can help. So, we're two-thirds of the way around. That didn't take very long. So, I'm going to put this up on the Facebook page, possibly YouTube later, and I'll be back when it's time to patina and foil, or wax, sorry. Take care. Thanks for watching.